Hi, welcome to What's Happening. Here are the top five stories. At number five, Nigeria's Vice President Yemi Osinbajo unveiled the first electric car assembled in Nigeria, among other locally manufactured products, at the ongoing exhibition in Abuja on Tuesday. Speaking at the Made in Nigeria fair at the Eagle Square, Osinbajo said the development was fantastic and that the making of the innovative car called Kona Electric Car is an evidence of what is possible in Nigeria. After the exhibition, the Vice President also visited the headquarters of the Federal Road Safety Corps, where he inaugurated the National Traffic Radio 107.1 FM. He said the radio station was an important and strategic initiative in several respects. The service will enable effective dissemination of relevant information on road safety and the provision of up-to-date information on road conditions, as well as traffic status and security to the public. At number four, the governor of the Central Bank of Nigeria, Godwin Emefiele, has said that the country's Apex Bank will assist the Central Bank of Gambia to print its currency. Emefiele disclosed this on Tuesday during a two-day visit by a delegation from the Central Bank of Gambia, led by its governor, Mr. Boa Saidi. Emefiele said this in response to a request by the Bank of Gambia for a possible partnership with CBN to tackle acute currency shortages, among other currency management challenges in their country. Saidi told the CBN governor that its current printer, the La Rue of London, was expensive and continued patronage was unsustainable. In response, Emefiele assured them that the CBN had extremely competitive advantage to undertake the printing of Gambia's currency, adding that the Nigerian security printing and minting had a lot of idle capacity to meet the demand of the CBG. At number three, Anambra State Government and the State Police Command have debunked reports that the disbanded Bakassi Boys have returned to the state. The Commissioner of Information and Public Enlightenment, C. Adinuba, acknowledged that Oka community put a security arrangement in place to curb cult activities, but they were not Bakassi Boys. While the State Police Public Relations Officer, Ikenga Tochukwu, insisted that the command had no knowledge of the presence of the outfit in the state. Reports had emerged on Monday claiming the dreaded vigilante group returned to some parts of Anambra State and that they were seen in vans singing and warning criminals. At number two, the ambassador of the Democratic People's Republic of Korea, John Cho, has expressed the desire of the North Korean government to enjoy closer ties with the All Progressives Congress-led Nigerian government. The ambassador spoke through an interpreter at a meeting held on Tuesday with the National Secretary of the APC, Senator John Akpanaudoyedege, who represented the APC National Chairman, Governor Mai Malabuni, in Abuja. The diplomat said the Central Committee of the Workers' Party of Korea was impressed with the achievements of the APC and Caretaker Extraordinary Convention Planning Committee under Buni's leadership. At number one, the federal government has announced that it is expecting to receive additional 3.92 million doses of the Oxford-AstraZeneca COVID-19 vaccines through the COVID-19 Vaccines Global Access Facility. The Executive Director of the National Primary Healthcare Development Agency, Faisal Shuaib, announced this during a media briefing in Abuja on Tuesday. Shuaib said the additional doses of vaccines are expected in the country latest by August 2021. He said, "We now have information that Nigeria will get 3.92 million doses of Oxford-AstraZeneca by the end of July or early August. Always remember to wear your mask, wash your hands and stay safe. That's all for now. See you next time on What's Happening."